Subscribe my channel for physics. Gee, and neat.
Students, good morning all of you. Today in our video, I want to explain how we can derive the Gauss law from Coulomb's inverse square law. The derivation of the Gauss law from the Coulomb's inverse square law. Okay, let us see. So at first, Coulomb's inverse square law. So Coulomb's inverse square law, it is right, the force acting between two charges is equal to the force acting between two charges. For suppose here there is a charge Q and there is another charge Q naught. These two charges are separated in a small distance. Then the force of attraction or repulsion should be acting between them. The force of attraction or the repulsion is always directly proportional to the product of two charges and also inversely proportional square distance between them. From these two we can write that F proportional Q, Q naught by R square. If proportion should be omitted, then it is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, it is the constant of the free space, it is Q Q naught by R square. So this is the Coulomb's inverse square law in the electrostatics. Now coming to the Gauss law in electrostatics. So Gauss law, it is nothing but the net magnetic flux of any closure surface that is equal to or pi it is equal circle integral of E dot ds, it is equal to 1 by epsilon naught time of charge enclosed by the surface, that is Q net, net charge enclosed by the surface. From this you can write that E dot ds, it is equal, circle integral E dot ds is equal Q by epsilon naught. This is the Gauss law in electrostatics. Okay, so now we have to derive this Gauss law from the, by the using of Coulomb's inverse square law. So here, from Coulomb's inverse square law, we have to write that the electric field, intensity of the electric field should be known as the force acting upon a charge. If a charge can be moves left side, then F by Q naught, it is equal to intensity of the electric field, that should be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. So this is the intensity of electric field. That is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. So by the using of this one, you can prove the Gauss law. Okay, let us see how we can solve it. Let us assume a charge is here, a charge Q is here, and there may be a field around of it. At this point, there is a point charge Q naught is there, the distance of R. Okay, so in the area of ds, the surface of the ds, so here the ds and E will be having in same direction. So according to the Gauss law, circle integral E dot ds is equal Q by epsilon naught. You have to take in the LHS, which it is E dot ds, it is equal E from the Coulomb's inverse square law. You can write that 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square dot ds. In the vector form of this one, you can write that this is R cube and whereas R dot ds. Okay, r cube, whereas r dot ds. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r cube. So these are the vectors. So now we can simplify that. Here it is equal 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r cube into r dot ds. It is equal to r ds cos theta. It is nothing but a b sin a dot b is equal to a b cos theta. So here ds and e, the angle between e and ds, the angle between r and ds, here also theta is equal 0, because 0 is equal to 1, hence you can write that 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r cube into r ds, where cos 0 is equal 1. Since here you can write that cos 0 is equal 1 here. Clear? From this you can write it is r square 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square ds. Okay, so this is the circle integral. You have to integrate circle integral of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square into ds. So you can write the outside of the integration. So it is, you can integral only the ds. You have to take the ds surface. It will be gives us the surface of the sphere. So that is nothing but capital S 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square into capital S. That is the surface of the, which we are assuming the circle or the sphere. Surface of the circle. Okay. So here that is S is equal to 4 pi r square. S is equal 4 pi r square. Hence you can substitute that circle integral of E dot ds, it is equal 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square into, what is that? 4 pi r square. It is r square, 4 pi, 4 pi cancelled out. It is equal q by epsilon naught. So it is circle integral of E dot ds. So where it is the, it is Gauss law. It is the Gauss law. Okay. So from where we have to derive that? It is the Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law. So Coulomb's, from the Coulomb's inverse square law, we can measure that Gauss law. So this is the proof of the Gauss law by the using of the Coulomb's inverse square law. And vice versa, we have to do the same. By the Gauss law, we can derive the equation of the Coulomb's inverse square law. Okay.